What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Mike. This is the Ultimate Tech Hub. Thank you for joining me. I really appreciate it. You guys are awesome. All right, today I'm gonna show you how to port forward. And to make sure you understand every step of the process, we're gonna go through a few examples. And today I'm gonna show you how to port forward on a PS5. But this port forwarding technique works with all PlayStation consoles, all Xbox consoles, and desktop computers. And it works with a bunch of other devices like cameras and IoT devices. But today we're gonna focus on gaming consoles because gaming is fun and IoT devices, not so fun. So first, what is port forwarding? To put it simply, port forwarding allows computers over the internet to connect with a computer or server within a private home network. This makes your gaming console or computer accessible to another computer through your network, which is being used to filter traffic to multiple devices on your network. And through port forwarding, you specify that your PC or gaming console gets traffic on a specific port. And of course, I always get the question, is port forwarding safe? As far as port forwarding to gaming consoles, absolutely. When it comes to port forwarding to cameras or IoT devices, if your router's firmware is up to date and you're using a firewall, you should be good to go. All right, guys, now it's time to port forward on our PS5. One thing you need to realize when port forwarding, you need a static IP address. So in this video, it's a 2-for-1. I'm gonna show you how to set up a static IP address, and then I'm gonna show you how to port forward to that address. So let's get started. All right, the first thing we have to do is find the IP address on the console. So go to your console, go to settings and network settings. Look for the IP address on your console and look and see if it's set up as dynamic or static. If it's already set up as static, you're good to go. However, if it's set to dynamic, we gotta change this. So now we're in view connection status. To make this easy, to find out if you have a static IP address, if this is set to automatic, it is not static. So we need to go into manual. We're gonna do that in a minute. But a few things you wanna do here. Either take a picture with your camera, the IP address, the subnet mask, and default gateway. Take a picture or write this down. You'll need this for the static IP address setup. You're also gonna need a couple more things. You're gonna need the primary DNS and secondary. We'll get that off a router. So we'll go in the router settings and find those. So let's go ahead and set up a static IP address.
I'm gonna choose the wired LAN number 3, press the start button on the controller, go to advanced settings, go to manual, and then type in the IP address. Subnet mask. Default gateway. Primary DNS and secondary DNS. Then hit OK. Next, do a connection test to make sure it works. And you can see we're all good. And the speeds are pretty amazing. Now it's time to port forward.
So now we'll go back into the router settings and go to security and look for apps and gaming. And then we'll go to port forwarding, and this is where all the magic happens.
Now before we start port forwarding, we need to find the port numbers for the PS5. Whether it's web browsing, getting your email, or playing games, each service or application has a different port number assigned to it. In the absolute best place to find these port numbers is portforward.com. Okay, once you're at the homepage, click on port list. And then click on gaming platforms. Scroll down to the P, and then select how to forward ports to a PlayStation 5. And then scroll down about half the page to get the port numbers and the port ranges. So I'm gonna do port forwarding for the PS5 console, and then we're gonna port forward two more games. So make sure to keep watching to see which games we're gonna port forward. Okay, now that we have all our numbers, go back to the router settings. All right, guys, first thing you wanna do is name the application. We'll do PS5, then type in 1935 to 1935, and select both. Put in the IP address for the PS5. And FYI, our router supports TCP and UDP both. Some routers don't do this. Now when you're done, hit apply, and we'll do the next set of numbers. Once again, we'll name it PS5. And for this one, we'll do the range, 3478 through 3480. And once again, it's both and same IP address. Hit apply. So once again, add another port, PS5 3074 to 3074, both. And once again, same IP address. And now hit apply. And now we're going to add two more games. A lot of these port numbers and ranges will overlap with most games. So for instance, Call of Duty Warzone has the exact same numbers. So no need to add Call of Duty Warzone. However, let's go ahead and add Fortnite. So add new port, type in Fortnite, and you want to type in these numbers. And to be clear, some of the Fortnite numbers are the exact same numbers and ranges as the PS5. So only add the numbers that do not match. And then once you're done, hit apply. And we're gonna add Gran Turismo 6. And once again, some of the numbers were the same as the PS5 numbers. So we'll add the ones that did not match up. When doing port forwarding, you cannot have spaces, or you get this error. Alright guys, we port forwarded PS5, Fortnite, and Gran Turismo 6. And to be clear, most of the games for PS5 are included in the PS5 ports. So simply having the PS5 port forwarding, almost all the games should work perfectly. And we're going to do one more speed test real quick. And our speeds are even faster than before. So port forwarding does work to increase your internet speed. Just be aware that port forwarding may not increase your internet speed. There's many factors involved. But as far as for online gaming, port forwarding does help to reduce lag, slow gameplay, and even server connection errors. Well guys, if you made it this far, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. You guys are awesome. And remember, if you found this video helpful and you liked it, give a thumbs up and share it. And I'll see you in the next video real soon. Peace.